wonderful parents and lovely pupils. You welcome back to our social studies class, as it feels always exciting to be back with you. Now, our topic is community leadership. Community, C-O-M-M-U-N-I-T-Y, community leadership, L-E-A-D-E-R-S-H-I-P, leadership, community leadership. We are going to see the meaning of leadership. Then we talk about types of community leaders. In this very lesson, we are going to talk about just one type of community leader, and that is a traditional ruler, or you see, traditional rulers. We will see examples of traditional rulers, and finally, we will see duties of a traditional ruler. Now, what is leadership? Leadership is the ability to lead people towards achieving their common goals. Leadership is the ability to lead people towards achieving their common goals. Again, leadership is the ability to lead people towards achieving their common goals. A leader could be male or female. Yes, a male could be a leader, or a female could be a leader. A leader must know is or are people and their culture very well. A leader can emerge through election. That is, the person with the highest number of votes. A leader can be selected by tradition to inherit the position of his dead father or ancestor. For example, an Oba or Emir. Now, to the type of leadership we are going to talk about today, traditional rulers. Traditional rulers. A traditional ruler is a community leader. Examples of traditional rulers in Nigeria are the Shegu of Borno, the Shegu of Borno, the Emir of Kano, the Emir of Kano, the Obi of Onitsha, the Obi of Onitsha, the Oba of Benin, the Oba of Benin, the Oni of Ife, the Oni of Ife, the Obon of Calabar, the Obon of Calabar, the Sultan of Sokoto, the Sultan of Sokoto, the Lamido of Adamawa, the Lamido of Adamawa, etc. Those are examples of traditional rulers. Now, in many communities, A son inherits the position of his father. In other cases, the community, kingdom, or emirate may be divided into sections or houses from which kings are selected in turn. This is the rotatory system. A system where kingdoms, emirates, communities are divided into sections or houses from which kings are selected in turn is known as the rotatory system. Okay? In many communities, we have king makers. And in those communities where there are no kings, the eldest man is usually made the leader. Communities where there are kingmakers are there, but in other communities where there are no kings, the eldest man is made the leader. Now to duties of a traditional ruler. Duties of a traditional ruler. Number one, they are usually called upon to settle disputes. For example, land and sectional or family problems. Duties of a traditional ruler. Number one, they are usually called upon to settle disputes. For example, land and sectional or family problems. Number two, they promote community development projects. They promote community development projects. Number three, they represent their communities during discussions with external agents and with government. They represent their communities during discussions with external agents and with government. Number four, they help to maintain law and order. They help to maintain law and order. Number five, they help the police during their investigations. They help the police during their investigations. Those are the duties of a community leader, or you say a traditional ruler. Remember that we have said that leadership is the ability to lead people towards achieving their common goals. A leader could be male or female. A leader can emerge through election, that is the person with the highest number of votes, or a leader can be selected by tradition to inherit the position of his dad, of his dead father or ancestor, for example, an oba or emir. Do not forget that a traditional ruler is a community leader. That's the end of our lesson for today. Your assignments will be given to you. Please study well and do well to do your assignments. Stay safe. I love you all.